How many of you have had breakfast this morning? Well, a very good news to all of you because today we're going to eat.
Yay!
Woo!
Yes, you heard me right. Today we're going to eat. Now, before I begin our speech, today's food will be free flow, so remember to pass the food around to the people beside you and to those behind you. Now, all of you must be wondering, what has this got to do with our speech? Well, a very good morning to Miss Esther and Miss Kelly and my fellow friends. My name is Nicholas, and today I'm joined with my two other group mates, Andrew and Shen Yong. So, indulging in our food today, me and my group will teach you how to conquer a buffet. Now, today we're going to touch on some of the common mistakes which you guys have probably done at a buffet and potentially fix them. We'll also give you a few extra tips on how to conquer this buffet. So without further ado, I'll pass this time to Shen Yong to teach you what to do before entering the battlefield.
Okay, thank you, Nick. First of all, do your research. Know which buffet is right for you. Buffets have offered many cuisines, or they can just offer one single cuisine. I mean, it's not nice to just go to a buffet only just because it is cheap, but doesn't offer the cuisine that you like. So, and the most expensive buffet may not necessarily be the best one for you for certain reasons. And so do your research before choosing a buffet. Moving on, I cannot emphasize this point enough, but please do not starve yourself before going to a buffet. Why do I say this? Some of you say, they think, oh, I have more room in my stomach if I starve myself. No, that is not true, okay? When you starve yourself, you're basically causing your stomach to shrink. So you actually have less room in your stomach and you cannot eat a lot. So what do people recommend that you do? People and myself, we recommend that you have a light meal 2 to 3 hours before the actual buffet. This will cause your stomach to expand and thus giving you more room for your meal. In terms of what to eat, I would suggest either fruits or maybe some biscuits or whatnot. Okay, moving on. Dress appropriately. Okay, so as you can see here, there are two people here. This is what you should dress like, which the shirt is loose fitting with room for your stomach to expand. And rather loose jeans. If it's too tight, you will feel uncomfortable. And especially if you go out with friends, it will be very uncomfortable and maybe embarrassing. On this side, you have what you shouldn't wear. You should wear not white clothes, which are so form-fitting that the second you just eat a little bit, your stomach shows through your clothes, as well as tight jeans. Now, moving on to my last point. Stay hydrated. Now, water doesn't actually help with the digestive process in the stomach. It helps later on by helping you to absorb your nutrients and other things that come from your food. So, before going to the buffet, I would recommend and ask you all to stay hydrated. Okay? Before going to the buffet. And now I'll pass my time on to Nick to tell you what to do during the battle.
Alright, thank you, Shen. Now, when you go into a buffet, this is probably the first thing you'll see. You see a bunch of food, and before you start taking your food, it's important that you actually take a tour around the buffet. So, start looking at the options, such as the available appetizers, main course, and also desserts. You want to pre-plan, you want to look at the available options, some of that you cannot get at home, and those that you can cook or those who cannot cook at all. There's a very large variety of food available there. It's important that you actually start pre-planning how you want to tackle, which one you want to go first, and which one you want to go last. Now, next point. Now this is a tip that I want to show you guys. Do not start with glutinous food or starchy food such as the pasta. Instead, start with something light, such as a soup or a dessert. Because this type of foods are actually easier to process, and it can help process the other foods easier on later on. Sorry, we're on a budget. Okay, so yeah, let's moving on. This is actually a tip which we actually did some research on, and it's actually called the small plate and the big plate at a buffet. So normally this there are two types of plate offered at a buffet, the smaller ones and the bigger ones. And it shows that, well, using a bigger plate, you're actually taking a lot more food especially during your first serving. So try using something smaller, because it feels like you're actually taking a lot, but in reality you're actually taking a little bit. So by using smaller plates, you're actually able to go for more servings, and it's a good way to strategize as well. So watch out for that. Now, moving on. Eat slowly. So, this is actually a common mistake which we actually found at a buffet. It's that people eat like that. And it's really, really important that you guys do not, because you actually fill yourself up really quick. You should try to enjoy the process just like the kid on the right. And this is a tip. Pace yourself. Eat slowly. And most importantly, take a break. Maybe start talking to your friends, or maybe just like look at your phone, or just relax for a while before going to the second serving. Because the most important thing at the buffet is that you maximize your time and the amount of food that you can take in, right? So, next slide. Now this is what we all look forward to at the buffet. Now imagine this. At the buffet, you start eating really fast, and after probably one serving, you're filled. And then you turn to your right, you walk to the dessert bar, and this is what you see. But then you try to reach out for that one chocolate, but your heart says yes, but your stomach says no. So this is very important. Pace yourself. Eat slowly, pre-plan, so you can actually maximize your stomach and actually go for this food. So with that, we actually start giving up the food. So eat slowly and share. Now, I'll pass my time on to Andrew to continue on with you.
Thank you, Nicholas. Alright. So to speak, if you really want to enjoy the buffet experience and maximize the cost effectiveness, go premium. Pick foods that you wouldn't cook for yourself. I'm pretty sure that the majority of foods that buffets offer have like toast and scrambled eggs, and I know they look tasty, but the thing is, you can always cook them at home anytime. If you go to all-you-can-eat buffet and you just get a plate full of toast and eggs, then what's so special about going to a buffet and spending so much money? Go for a food that can make the meal feel like a treat. Okay, let's be honest here. Go for expensive food. Don't waste your time and money on stupid eggs and toast. It's like being blinded by those glorious sights of bacon strips and forsaking the real good stuff, like tenderloin flaps. Go grab those quality foods like proteins, ribeye steak, or seafood, a shrimp. And if you're not a fan of top meat, just munch on those smoked salmon and grilled trout. And if you're a vegan, so if you can't have meat at all, it's totally fine. Just dig in some gourmet vegan food. The same rule applies to your finale. Keep away from those ice creams. You can always buy ice creams at any grocery stores, right? If you successfully made a reservation in your stomach to stack up some desserts, Well, you can have another piece of cake, but my suggestion is fresh fruits. Both healthy and not so cheap. And frozen yogurt with a bowl of fresh fruits would be a perfect idea. My second point is, I put significant importance on the drinks as well. I think drinking is as important as the eating process itself. Okay, I'll have to admit that this may sound kind of obvious to you, but I have to say, try to avoid soda. The carbonation in the fizzy drinks are way more fulfilling than water is. Okay, so we all know that Shengyong mentioned earlier that you need to stay hydrated. But that's before the meal. You don't want to, while you're in the process of indulging, you don't want to be charging up too much liquid as that will fill you up. Go for juice or water instead. And if it's possible, avoid drinking any sugary drinks at all, because those are just extra calories that you could be using for actual foods. Drink teas instead. Peppermint is actually the best choice. It's great for getting your digestive system going, as well as soothing your stomach and reducing bloating. Let your stomach have some damage control, okay? While doing our research, most of the articles and papers that we have read suggested to exercise or at least take a walk after eating a buffet. And let me be just honest with you. You would definitely have a food coma after the big game, and there's nothing you can do about it. Don't try to overcome the nature by exercising when you're already tired. It will only make you more exhausted. Just accept it and embrace it. Dream about all the delicious food you just ate and think of what food you would like to have for the next time. Sleep tight and make sure that nobody's using the toilet next morning. Okay, to give you a summary of all the things that we have talked about on our group speech on how to maximize the buffet experience and to best enjoy the buffet in the most efficient way. Shengyong gave you some instructions on what to do before going to the buffet. First, don't starve yourself. Because if you starve the whole day long, just like I used to do before going to the buffet, your stomach actually starts to shrink and eventually you won't be able to fit in as much food as you want. And second, stay hydrated. It will not only keep your stomach stretched, but also help your digestion system. You don't want to have a hiccup or bloating after the big game, right? And third, don't forget to dress comfortably. And fourth, do a bit of research before going to the buffet on what you want to dig in. And after entering the battlefield, as Nicholas mentioned earlier, first, take a look at the foods they offer and start off with the appetizers, like a soup or salad, to tell your stomach that it's time to work. Don't start with carbohydrates. Stay away from those pastas and potatoes. And second, it's very important to take small portions of the many kinds of food so that you know what's good and what to go back for the second round. Third, eat slowly. No one is going to chase you out for eating too slowly, and if you can, try to get small plates rather than those big ones. And I have told you to first go premium. Expensive food that you don't get to eat every day if you really want to exploit what you paid for. And second, keep away from soda and fizzy drinks. If it's possible, just keep away from any sugary drinks. And finally, when you're done with everything, forget about exercising and just go to bed. Dining at buffet is always an exciting thing, but it's better when it's done right. I hope you all enjoyed the little buffet we offered, and I would like to end our presentation here. Thank you.